Welcome to Jimmy Buffett's Equal Strain on All Parts album track by track special.
All I know for certain is my gummy just kicked in.
Now your hosts, producers and Coral Reefer band members, Mac McAnally and Mike Utley.
You're listening to SiriusXM's Radio Margaritaville. I'm Mac McAnally. The album kicks off with the University of Bourbon Street, song one, track one. And it's an appropriate place for Jimmy to kick it off because he started, that's where he started, is in New Orleans, learning how to be a musician and an entertainer, at professional Jimmy Buffett. That's where he sort of started. And Mike knows more about it than me, but I've had people tell me stories about the fact that Jimmy, when he was playing in rowdy bars in New Orleans where nobody pays attention generally, just would not allow them to not pay attention. He would get pitchers of beer and walk out over the tables in the bar and refill their beers, just like, you will not ignore me. And that quality that he had went through all of the whole rest of his life, every aspect of it. He was not to be ignored. And this song is talking about how he learned that, how he learned the tools of the trade, as it were. What a fine song it revealed itself as last January in Blackbird Studio in Nashville.
I love the story that Will Kimbrough, the co-writer, because Jimmy had given him, he gave all of you guys assignments to do it, and he would give this sort of the musical idea. And he said, we need a song like J.J. Cale. And so Will writes the song in the J.J. Cale sort of loping sort of country-esque ballad.
Mm-hmm.
And we get to the studio, and we're about to record it, and Jimmy says, let's honor Alan Toussaint. Let's play some word. And so Will sort of
second line. Here we go.
I didn't write it that way. I said, well, here we go.
And now that we've totally defined the thing.
I guess the point of going to college was to acquire myself a little knowledge and help me figure out what life is really all about. It made Pete and JD happy and set me wild and free. Then I danced out of Mississippi to the University of Bourbon Street. I sang, hey, Pocky Way, on the streetcar headed uptown. I went to class every day and never wore a frown. I was taught by the Neville brothers, Benny Spellman, and a whole lot of others. That brass band blew my mind when I joined in the second line. I felt the power of the gree-gree. Got my soul saved by the backbeat. I was branded by Jean Lafitte at the University of Bourbon Street. I sang on a paddle wheel boat, floated down the Mississippi, helped build a Mardi Gras float, and spoke to John with a beautiful hippie. I heard a church choir sing, changed my guitar strings, thought things just couldn't get better, till I walked to the Central Grocery and had myself a muffaletta. I took my lunchbox to the streetcar, that Tennessee named Desire. Then I followed my dancing feet to the University of Bourbon Street. We got high class, low rent, voodoo information, Pat O'Brien's hurricane accreditation, old school sex education. And I learned how to eat, from the music and the people to the cooking and the joy. It really ain't a mystery. I just followed my dancing feet to the University of Bourbon Street. I got my lucky dog PhD at the University of Bourbon Street. Yeah, I just followed my dancing feet to the University of Bourbon Street. And a po' boy master's degree at the University of Bourbon Street. It's all sweet, darling.
University of Bourbon Street.
Hand me that umbrella. Follow me to school.
University of Bourbon Street. University of Bourbon Street.
You're listening to SiriusXM's Radio Margaritaville. I'm Mac McAnally. Bubbles up. The idea for the song came out of Jimmy did, he didn't do the entire Navy SEAL training, but he did a thing with that the Navy SEALs do where they drop you into water with gear on and you go 15 feet down in the water and you got to figure out where in the hell you are. I can't imagine why he would want to do that, but he wanted to do it. Our buddy Admiral Vest from the Navy said, you know, well, if you want to do it, you can do it, but we're not going to baby you. You're going to have to do it the way we do it. And Jimmy said, that's fine. Just give me some advice. And he said, well, when you're down there and you don't know where you are, follow the bubbles. Bubbles up, bubbles go up. And they turned that into just this wonderful positive message that applies to everything. It doesn't matter what you apply that to, you're going to feel better if you listen to Bubbles Up. And Jimmy did sing the hell out of it. He did a great job on it. And as cool of a set of lyrics as there are on the record, Will and Jimmy deserve big kudos for that.
They do. And, you know, it's amazing the vocal that he got on it because, you know, he was not feeling 100% anytime we were doing this record. Although he put his heart 100% into it. To capture a vocal like that was amazing.
And you can hear that heart in there. I think, you know, for anybody that saw Sir Paul McCartney, Cartney's post about that song, he said he thought that may be the best he ever heard Jimmy Buffett sing, and it was probably more heart than vocal cord, but it's beautiful.
When this world starts a reeling from that pressure drop feeling, we're just treading water each day. There's a way to feel better, be well set to weather the storms till the sun shines again. When your compass is spinning and you're lost on the way, like a leaf in the wind, friend, hear me when I say, bubbles up, they will point you towards home. No matter how deep or how far you roam, they will show you the surface, the plot and the purpose. So when the journey gets long, just know that you are loved. There is light up above, and the joy is always enough. Bubbles up. To my friends who are jealous, when melancholy knocks, sometimes they let her in to sit and share stories of flops and of glories. It ain't half as bad as the bends. Sometimes living's a struggle, multiplied double, but they love it too much for the party to end. Bubbles up, they will point you towards home. No matter how deep or how far you roam, they will show you
the surface, the plot and the purpose. So when the journey gets long, just know that you are loved. There's light up above, and joy there's always enough. Bubbles up, let's pop a cork. To the rough and the right, to the bright blazing days and the sweet starry nights. Bubbles up, they will point us towards home. No matter how deep or how far we roam, they will show you the surface, the plot and the purpose. So when the journey gets long, just know that you are loved. There's light up above, joy there's always enough. Bubbles up, bubbles up, bubbles.
You're listening to Sirius XM's Radio Margaritaville. I'm Mac McAnally. So, audience of one. Now, Jimmy had the title because that's gone back and forth from being a nightmare for him. Anytime he and I played golf and we went by where there were a bunch of empty bleachers, he's like, take a picture of that, because that's my nightmare, is empty bleachers, empty stands. But he ended up getting the notion of a title of audience of one, and he didn't really know what he wanted the song to be about. But it so happened over the holidays last year. But Mr. Utley and I were also fretting that we didn't really have finished songs yet for the record, and we were about to record it.
By the way, I looked at the email that we got. It was the 12th of December.
Right.
There was nothing written.
Nothing.
Titles. I said, I can't believe there. This is and what was our first day in the studio? Like the 13th. Of January?
Yeah, I think that's right. Yeah.
Yeah. We were fretting a little bit.
We were. But the assignment for audience of one was to our kids, Mick and Aaron, and they just happened to get stranded at my house over the holidays. We had eaten all the leftovers we could hold, and we came up with a little music groove, and we kind of got a nice running start, and we got Jimmy on a Zoom call and whipped that song out during the holidays in a tryptophan carb loading between Christmas and New Year's, and it turned into a song, and it is actually quite a fun piece of work, and it's not a take on songwriting that I'd heard before, so I was proud. Well, anybody that gets to co-write with their kids and their in-laws, you know, that is a wonderful thing. And anybody that gets to co-write with Jimmy Buffett is a lucky son of a gun, too. So,
one hand clapping, five toes tapping, a neighbor napping across the hall. Second guess, this song is a mess. Make a little progress, even if it's small. All I know to tell is do it till you get it right. Play it to an audience of one, better than an audience of none. Play it to an audience somewhere, better than a bunch of folks not there. You could still have for an audience of one.
It was a big night, marquee lights. I seemed to set impossible sights. Media post drew a curious ghost. Is she a band or a miffed housewife? All I know to tell is do it till you get it right. Play into an audience of one, better than an audience of none. Play into an audience somewhere. No other job compares. You can still have a lot of fun. Give it all you got for an audience of one. Never alone, hold the phone without fail. No trepidation, my motivation is a standing ovation from a wagon tail. All I know to tell you is we finally got it right. Play into an audience of one, better than an audience of none. Play into an audience somewhere, better than a bunch of not there. You can still have a lot of fun. Giving it all you got for an audience of one. Yeah. Un fou d'un. Un modeste cédéon.
You're listening to SiriusXM's Radio Margaritaville. I'm Mike Utley. All I know is Jimmy kept talking about dinner with, is it Paul's wife, Nancy? Is that correct?
It was the McCartneys and the Buffetts, I think.
Yeah, the Buffett. They were having dinner together. You know, she's sitting there and they're having conversation. And she said, my gummy just kicked in. Anytime somebody says a lie, he would take it and run with it. He sure ran with it with this one. So he got the mayors involved in it. Roger, Pete Mayer might be the biggest Beatle fan. So they were the perfect people to assign to help come up with the, my gummies just kicked in. So,
and Miss Tina contributed as well. Yeah, so between Roger and Pete and Tina, we had a marriage of the expertise of gummies and Beatles and Coral Reeferdom. And it was a good thing. Then you know, you add Jimmy and Tina and Raj and Pete, and then you throw the Coral Reefer Band, and then as an afterburner to all that, you get Sir Paul McCartney to play bass on the track, and it's like we won a couple of lotteries.
Yeah, that's the biggest smile I've seen Jimmy have ever, when he's sitting there with Paul, Sir Paul, at A&M Studios after Paul had overdubbed, you know, the bass part.
I had a hard time not making it louder than the vocal.
Yes.
No good. When we mixed it, I was like, is that enough? We need more Paul.
A summer party on the South Shore. Wine and laughter and a little bit more. From a pretty girl next to me out of the blue. Came a proclamation only heard by few. Don't know. My gummy just kicked in. Feeling no pain, she ejected from her chair. Sprang up on the table and let down her hair. A procession of expression, frozen in shock. Then the 60s came alive and she yelled, let's rock. Don't know where I'm going. All I know for certain is my gummy just kicked in. Tantalizing, tempting state I'm in.
acapella frogs struck the big bass sound. Then the full moon rose and the sun went down. The gummy in her tummy wasn't breaking any laws. She rode a bus float in her own Mardi Gras. My gummy just, my gummy just kicked in. A summer party on the South Shore. My gummy just kicked in. My gummy just kicked in. Wow.
You're listening to SiriusXM's Radio Margaritaville. I'm Mac McAnally. Next, we got close calls, and there are close calls involved in almost every aspect of Jimmy's life and several involved in this song, but we touched on a few in this song with his sort of famous losing battle with Buford Pusser from the Walking Tall movies. Buford sort of beat Jimmy up on the day that they recorded God's Own Drunk back in the 70s in Nashville, and that lives in the chorus of this song, and I'm glad that it does.
Well, I just want to thank the bellhop that stopped Jimmy and Sammy Creason from going back down to duke it out with Buford, because they were going. I didn't see Buford, but I saw them come back. They knocked on the door and he said, please don't go back down there. You know who that guy is. And yeah. Sammy had a tire tool in his hand.
Yep, that's right. And according to Eddie Raven, who was there, he was the bass player in the band. The bellman called Jimmy. He didn't know who Jimmy was, but he said, hold on, little Benny Rooster.
That was a little rooster.
So you would have all the testosterone of a full-size rooster. He called Jimmy little Benny Rooster. He said, you don't need to fight him. That's Big Stick. That's a little walk-soft Big Stick man. You don't need... And that's 1974, is that right? Is that when, or two, or whenever it was?
Yeah, it was 74. Yeah. Boy, we had just done God's Own Drunk. That's why the tequila was out
that
of the studio.
Yeah. That's why he was drunk. And you know, where would we go from this conversation except let's listen to Close Calls.
Just to be alive. I fought Buford Pusser in a honky-tonk joint. He whipped my ass. That's beside the point. Close calls, close calls. Lucky just to be alive. Been in lots of tight spots, so many that I can't explain. Big shots, bone mutts, I don't always use my brain. Scuba diving, Pensacola, 120 feet down. I'm so glad that buddy breathed me, or I guess I would have drowned. Close calls, close calls, I don't always use my brain. Life can be a pickle or a stalk of sugar cane. One day you're wrestling gators, next day you're singing Never Been to Spain. In Spanish. In
close call. I will survive. Brick walls, big balls. Lucky just to be alive. I fought Buford Pusser in a honky-tonk joint. He beat my ass. That's beside the point. Close calls, close calls. Lucky just to be alive. Close calls, close calls. I will survive. Close calls, close calls. Lucky just to be alive.
You're listening to SiriusXM's Radio Margaritaville. I'm Mike Utley. Here we are, equal strain on all parts. Well, Mr. McAnally, that was one of your assignments with Jimmy. He kept saying that his grandfather used to say that when he'd lay down on his hammock. And we asked him when Mac and I were up there a couple of days before he passed away. I said, Jimmy, is that your grandfather on the Buffett side? And then it was Pete's father that I think he said that it was the one that said this equal strain on all parts.
And I think he picked me because I'm from Mississippi and I dwell a lot in the land of grandfather's sayings. A lot of my songs have to do with things that my dad said and somebody's grandfather told me. I try to pick up wisdom from people that have been around the world longer than me. And I pride myself in having heard most of the sayings that get said, but I'd never heard equal strain on all parts. That's when Jimmy said his grandfather used to say that, I had never heard it, and I honestly couldn't fathom what he was talking about. But then when he said he was really defining a nap, I saw that what he's talking about is it's actually something good. If you've got equal strain on all parts, that means there's no particular strain on any part. So that's about as comfortable as you could be if there's equal strain on all parts. And it is kind of Mississippi in that it's, you know, if there's nothing really bad, it's good. I'm proud of being part of that song. And
yeah.
I wrote the little guitar part melody to the verse and chorus and sent it to Jimmy and from his initial idea. And he called me some curse words and said, you made me blank and cry.
Yeah.
And it happened a couple more times before we're done that, you know, that we all sort of teared up. When you get a song right and it tears you up, that's a good tear.
You bet.
That my grandfather said, not so little now here in my grown-up head. I didn't always see the wisdom at the time, but I'm older now. Right after lunch and a cafe royal, he'd take his combat nap and slip away to God knows where beneath his weathered cap and doze off with that parlance I came to understand. Equal strain on all parts. Son, whatever course you set, it'll ease the pain on backs and brains and hearts. It's a solid thing to wish for. It's the wrong thing to forget. Lying in this hammock now, it sure feels good to get an equal strain on all parts. For creatures big and small, cooling down our cylinders, living's a long haul. Jokes and songs and traveling, they lift the fall.
my new feet, cabin boys still steer me near and far. And I'll pass them on in poems and songs before I cross the bar. It's worth a little time and space to understand equal strain on all parts. Whatever course you set, it'll ease the pain on backs and brains and hearts. It's a solid thing to wish for, it's the wrong thing to forget. Lying in this hammock now, it sure feels good to get an equal strain on all parts.
You're listening to SiriusXM's Radio Margaritaville. I'm Mac McAnally. Well, I've been an ambassador for the Like My Dog song ever since the first time I heard it. We recorded a little demo of it, actually with the Coral Reefer Rhythm Section down in my studio, La La Land, in Muscle Shoals, right after Scotty wrote the song. And I've been a fan that long, and I've seen him sing it on stage, and I've lobbied Jimmy to record it before. Jimmy said, "Man, I really, really like that song, but what he goes to in the bridge," he said, "I just don't know if Mrs. Buffett would, if that would fly. I don't know if I could say that." So he passed on it. And then this year, we brought Scotty out to open the show for us. And Jimmy came out and watched the first show, and we played Like My Dog. And when he saw the crowd respond to that song, literally as soon as we walked off the stage, Jimmy's like, "I'm cutting that. We're definitely cutting that song." Everybody that hears that song loves it, and nobody loves their dog on earth more than Jimmy. That his dog's probably, you know, family, dogs, show, somewhere in there is his top three, and I can't tell you for sure the order that they fall in, but his dogs are as important as anything. And all of the times we've ever seen him light up around those dogs, listening to him sing that song, you can see all those pictures without looking at them.
She never tells me that she's sick of this house. She never says, "Why don't you get off that couch?" She don't cause nothing when she wants to go out. I want you to love me like my dog. She never says I need a new attitude. Her and your sister ain't always in a few. When I leave the seat up, she don't think that it's rude. I want you to love me like my dog does, baby. When I come home, I want you to just go crazy. She never looks at me like she might hate me. I want you to love me like my dog. She never acts like she don't care for my friends. She never asks me, "Where the hell have you been?" She don't play dead anytime I walk in. I want you to love me like my dog does, honey. She never says, "I wish you made more money." She always thinks that for my fingers funny. I want you to love me like my dog. She don't get mad at me and throw a major fit, 'cause I said her sister was a bitch. I want you to love me like my dog does, baby. When I come home, I want you to just go crazy. She never looks at me like she might hate me. I want you to love me like my dog. Why won't you love me like my dog does, baby?
You're listening to SiriusXM's Radio Margaritaville. I'm Mac McAnally.
During the making of this album, Jimmy wanted to include a lot of different aspects of, like, others' titles that for, like, Volcano, the Jolly Man, and he was a fan of Kassab's song, Utley. So he was going to use the idea of musically that idea and come up with this song, Tea Punch Cafe. He started writing it. He got Angelique Kidjo, who's a famous performer in Europe, in the West Indies. He got her to sing on this record. The funny story is we had a bridge that we were going to have to put a solo on. And she, after she had done her part, she actually sang something on that bridge that's the most incredible thing I'd ever heard. It's sort of a scat, Creole scat thing, and it's just beautiful. It worked out. We didn't have to come up with some sort of solo. But as far as the lyrics, he brings Jolly Man into the story, and
he was always one to quote pre-existing work, you know, to re-refer to things that are across the albums. He was just a naturally clever guy. So he'll work in three or four Buffett songs into a new Buffett song. You get a little extra value for the dollar.
Above the entrance curtain hangs a well-used frying pan.
The owner's not the Aga Khan.
It is the Jolly Man.
Ula! Ule! Ula! Ule! Ula!
And the trip from the Pleiades, Desdemona came in her rocket ship.
Eddie brought the burgers, Banky brought his band, and the little prince at Toulamont did the biggie in the sand.
Hey!
Ula! Ule! Ula!
Now the party's done, fun tickets gone. We sang and laughed and hoped.
Then I woke back in 20 beneath my telescope. Galaxies and Nautilus shells
look the same to me.
So ask yourself this question:
how couldn't it be?
Yeah.
You're listening to SiriusXM's Radio Margaritaville. I'm Mac McAnally. This one was probably the hardest song for me to figure out how to make it work. Jimmy's always had in his internal biography that's going in his head all the time. He's always been concerned with, if I disappear from the world, here's where I might be. He's told me that several times. He used to say, you know, if nobody can find me, maybe you should look at Mama's Fish House in Maui. That was what he said that for 10, 12 years or so. But in the last couple of years, he's like, you know, maybe a pub in Portugal or a PEI, look for me there. And then he's like, I want that to be a song. And I've written songs from a lot of angles, but I couldn't figure out a way to make that be a song for a long time. We had to play Tetris with the words and get it back and forth. And he was smart enough to bring in Lenny Glock, who's up there in PEI. So he had some of the vernacular up there and some of the actual references.
Man, I need to say this. Mac actually made this thing really sing. The way he put it together.
Well, thank you, Mike. I'm glad I started with a lot of hair because it involved a little bit of pulling before we got it right, I think. But I just wanted it to end up having the same kind of joy in it that Jimmy had when he first talked about it in the beginning. And you know, sometimes when you've been beating your head against one for a while, it's hard to remember that it's a joyful thing. But this one still is. I still enjoy listening. And he was particularly concerned that it have a real Portuguese fado guitar.
Right. And so you had to learn to play it.
He had to find one, and I had to learn to play it. That's how it worked out.
You were given that task.
I was given that task, and I also had to learn to tune it, which was the first day. And the second day, I had to learn how to play it.
Yeah.
I guess that I was born with that nomad gene. There's very little of this planet that I have not seen. Everybody's on a soapbox, influencers and phones. Tick-tock, Tommy Rock, round the clock, but I'm still thinking Rolling Stones. So where am I gonna go when the volcanoes blow? Everybody's asking all the time. Contemplating Malbec Bay or a beach bar near Sagre, I'm sure I'll find a way. Till then I'll be in the conga line.
Up in Portugal or PEI, laying low, staying high. I got my good friends close and trouble far away. Music on a beach cross, singing sands. No big deal, no master plan. We'll be alright come Monday.
Across the ocean on friendly archipelagos, where women sing to Gaia and the marijuana grows.
I'm thinking garden of the gulf, where the Portuguese fished long ago. Speak a little Mi'kmaq when I can, and in Cavendish do the dough to dough.
Where am I gonna go when the volcanoes blow? Everybody's asking all the time. Contemplating Malbec Bay or a beach bar near Sagre, I'm sure I'll find a way. Till then I'll be in the conga line.
Up in Portugal or PEI, laying low, staying high. I got my good friends close and trouble far away. Music on a beach cross, singing sands. No big deal, no master plan. We'll be all right.
Monday.
Everybody's playing TikTok, Tommy Rod. And I still love the Rolling Stones. Life is always better when you add a little island. A lot of oysters, love and wine. Maybe a purple PEI with somebody singing in Portuguese on the sandbar.
You're listening to SiriusXM's Radio Margaritaville. I'm Mike Utley. Nobody works on Friday. Well, that's not necessarily so, but what's the great thing about this is Jimmy divvied this out to the kids, Mick and Aaron. They came up, he wanted a Memphis groove, and they did it to the T. I mean, they just came up in the backgrounds, and it's just so musical, and it fits the album so well because it gives a different dimension, a different genre. But then Jimmy got in that line about the rosé. What was it? Confritters and rosé?
Yep.
Confritters and... Actually, that was going to be a title, but he didn't...
Confritters and red wine.
And red wine. Yeah, that's it. Yeah.
Yeah, he doesn't waste anything.
No, he does not. He did not waste anything on this album.
That might have been an entree on the next album, but it was a garnish on Friday.
And here we go. Here is Nobody Works on Friday.
Nobody works on Friday. Thursday night comes in hot. A little less work, make the same pay. Now I'm giving it all I've got. Nobody works on Friday. Nobody seems to care. Jump in the car, hop on a plane. Gotta get somewhere. When Friday comes along, we'll be gone, 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 gone.
Nobody works on Friday
anymore.
Nobody works on Friday.
The French got a month of joie de vivre. The Aussie 6 weeks to grill, mate. Spain takes a summer siesta. Bossa Nova heats up Brazil. But here the boss man's glued to the cameras, checking productivity. But the company time's not yours and mine. That's the point of flexibility. It took a global crisis to remind us there's so much more to life than working just a 4-day week. Nobody works on Friday. Thursday night comes in hot. A little less work, make the same pay. Now I'm giving it all I've got. Nobody works on Friday. Nobody seems to care. Jump in the car, hop on a plane. Gotta get somewhere. When Friday comes along, we'll be gone. The keys to success, cause life imitates ping pong. Maybe stumble across the job that sucks less, or put my thoughts in a song. It took a global crisis to remind us there's so much more to life than working just a 4-day week. Nobody works on Friday. Thursday got a booster shot. So what you gonna do with all that time? I'm feeling like a micro dot. Nobody works on Friday, praying for the sun to shine. Hey, pretty mama, how about the Bahamas? Confritters and red wine. When Friday comes along, we'll be gone, 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 gone.
Yeah.
You're listening to SiriusXM's Radio Margaritaville. I'm Mac McAnally. Jimmy and the great writer Carl Hyason are fishing buddies, and this was born of a fishing trip, I believe. And Carl and his buddies send what they call fishborn, just pictures of fish that they caught, to one another all the time. And Jimmy had not heard the term. And as Mike referred earlier, Jimmy doesn't waste terms. If he hears one, it's going to be a song. I don't want to exaggerate, but there's no way that I didn't get 20 drafts of fishborn.
No, exactly. There was definitely, before there was any music.
We got little bios of the characters in fishborn. He would write a backstory to the girl, so I would understand what it is that I'm playing an A minor chord about here.
Yeah.
And honestly, it sounds like we're joking about Jimmy, but the fact that he was so dedicated to every aspect of this song kind of gave me a clue that he was really serious about this record. You know, when somebody as good as him is digging in at the very beginning of the project, it's inspiring. He gave attention to detail to every bit of this album. And I don't really know, I couldn't tell you if he was thinking about it possibly being the last record. I don't know if he was or not, but he gave it every bit of his attention. And I'm so glad we followed it with him all the way to the end. He was really happy with the final product of this record. He was so proud.
Yeah.
And he knew it. He gave his heart to it. And it is one, you never know what's going to be your final statement, but if this is his, what a beautiful sentiment. And it's got all the joy of a Jimmy Buffett show, and it's got all the contemplation of his best ballads. It's just a really fine piece of work. And I'm just tickled to be, you know, riding shotgun with Mr. Utley in the making of it.
Proceeded with her master plan to make them both feel better. quite exciting, and the fish started biting, and holes were bending. Everybody loves a happy ending. Fish porn, it was a remedy. Everybody's going out to sea. Catch something for me.
You're listening to SiriusXM's Radio Margaritaville. I'm Mike Utley. Here we are, equal strain on all parts. Jimmy was telling the story about Johnny Holiday coming down to St. Bart's. There's a restaurant bar across from the cemetery. He just would see him there, sitting there, having a rum drink, and he was in his health and was declining. Jimmy came up with this song about thinking about what Johnny was thinking about. I mean, you know, this is where my final resting place. And that's where the song came from. And I think Lenny Gallant was part of this. Is that correct?
Yeah, Lenny and myself and Jimmy. I was not familiar with Johnny Holiday, but Johnny Holiday was sort of worshipped American music in the 50s and 60s. And Elvis was his hero, and he kind of became the French Elvis. After they sort of realized that Elvis was not going to tour Europe because Colonel Tom wouldn't let him, Johnny he sort of became the European Elvis. I had to learn about him when I was a co-writer on this song. I wasn't that aware of his career. They said at his funeral in Paris, there were 900,000 people in the funeral procession. So he was a very famous man. But in St. Bart's, everything's island-based. And Jimmy said none of the local St. Bart's could figure out how Johnny Holiday got such a nice spot in the cemetery when he died, because he wasn't as big a deal in St. Bart's on the island as he was in Europe and in France. And they're still like, who got bribed just so that he got that plot at the cemetery? So there's sort of that aspect of it as well. But it really fun song to write and play and be part of.
I had a dream I was down at JoJo's, having a burger neath the setting sun. Johnny was sitting in the corner, sipping on a glass of Dippah rum. He was checking out all of the tombstones across the cemetery in L'Orient. The stage was hung, the sound check done. He was ready for everyone. He strummed the guitar made of orchids, and the who's who all were there. Bill Haley, Carl Perkins, not to mention Buddy Holly, plus a couple of Jordanaires. Colonel Parker was lurking on a nearby beach with the contract full of deceit. But Johnny took the stage and tore up every page, and the crowd flew out of their seats. Johnny Holiday, leaping the net will appear. There's no other way you ever could have wound up here. All the blood and the sweat and the long shot bets and the things that the people say. You were more than just the French Elvis. You was Johnny Holiday. Was a sound come across the ocean from Memphis to the heart of France. It made Johnny dream and made the young girl scream and everybody sing and dance. And the sound spread through all nations, but the source only played in one. So Johnny made a plan and he started a band and then made himself a hell of a run. Johnny Holiday,
disappear. There's no other way you ever could have wound up here. All the blood and the sweat and the long shot bets and the things that the people say. You were more than just the French Elvis. You was Johnny Holiday. Champs-Élysées was crowded, almost a million strong, there to raise a glass and to watch him pass, maybe hoping for just one more song. Johnny Holiday, the leap in the net will appear. There's no other way we all could have wound up here. All the blood and the sweat and the long shot bets and the things that the people say. You were more than just the French Elvis. You was Johnny. Yeah, you was Johnny. Johnny Holiday.
You're listening to SiriusXM's Radio Margaritaville. I'm Mac McAnally. So when we got to, we were kind of late in their tracking process, but Jimmy just popped out and said, I want to sing this old Mary Black song, Columbus. We're going to do this song. And I didn't know the song. And we just pulled out an old YouTube of her singing it. And it's beautiful. I was surprised because I'd never heard him mention it before. And he's like, I always wanted to sing this song. And we sat out there and charted it, and he was not feeling well, and I was surprised that he wanted to go at a ballad, but this song apparently is important to him, and apparently he has sung it over the years, because from the very first run-through, he had it better than we did. He was ready.
He sure was. You know, usually Jimmy would let us know what he was listening to, but I'd never heard of this song. I never, you know, and he was such a fan of this song, and I just remember you and I, you know, taking the chords down. To track it, and I said, okay, well.
When he covered a song, it was a compliment. If a great writer covers somebody else's song, that's a compliment. That was one of the things that kept me going early on in the music business when Jimmy covered one of my songs. And the fact that he wanted to sing this song, and the fact that he worked so hard to sing it kind of out of his normal wheelhouse. That's not the normal Jimmy corner that he sings in, but he did a great vocal on.
He always did covers on his album, and he always made them his own. And yep. It was like, oh, he wrote that song. No, he didn't write, you know. Every album had at least two or three covers on it, and people always thought, well, that must be a Jimmy Buffett. It is a Jimmy Buffett tune, because he made it his own.
Better keep your distance from this whale. Better keep your boat from going astray. Find yourself a partner and treat them well. Try to give them shelter night and day. 'Cause here in this blue light, far away from the fireside, things can get twisted and crazy and crowded, and you can't even feel all right. So I dream of Columbus every time the panic starts. You dream of Columbus with your maps and your beautiful charts. You dream of Columbus.
with an ache in your traveling heart. See how the cormorant swoops and dives. Must be some thrill to go that deep. Down to the basement of this life. Down to where the mermaids gently sleep. Not like here in this blue light. Far away from the fireside, where things can get twisted and haunted and crowded. You can't even feel all right. So you dream of Columbus every time the panic starts. You dream of Columbus with your maps and your beautiful charts. You dream of Columbus. And as the tide must ebb and flow, I am dragged down under, and I wait the livelong day for an end to my. So I dream of Columbus every time the panic starts. I dream of Columbus with my maps and my beautiful charts. I dream of Columbus, and there's peace in this traveling heart. Dream of Columbus. I dream of Columbus. Dream of Columbus.
You're listening to SiriusXM's Radio Margaritaville. I'm Mike Utley. So I'd heard this song, but I didn't know that Emmylou Harris had sung on Bob's original version. So we're in the studio before the session starts, and Jimmy's about to, I think he was about to do vocals, but he calls Emmylou, and she's in town, and she's on her way to sing backgrounds on Dolly Parton's new album. And she says, well, I'll come by the studio. He got her to sing the duet. I mean, it was just so coincidental that she was in town. She wasn't on the road. And she did an amazing job. It was fun watching them work together.
It really was.
Yeah.
And she said, she commented that when she did the original with Dylan, that nobody gave her a copy of the lyrics. She just had to watch his mouth and try to sing with him. And so we made it a little bit easier than that.
We got her lyrics.
Yeah, we gave her a lyric sheet. So, but she's Emmylou Harris, so she's going to get it right either way. But it was awesome to see them together. And I also have to say, we were fooling around with the sequence all the way through the mastering process. And when we finally moved University of Bourbon Street to cut one, Jimmy said, that's it. New Orleans, that's where I started. That's where I wrote myself in. I learned what to do. It's a song line now. And he said, and down through Columbus is what I've done, and I've never been to Mozambique, so let's finish it with where I'd like to go. And he got to go singing it. That's how he got to go.
Fall in love, just me and you. There's lots of pretty girls in Mozambique, and plenty time for good romance. And everybody likes to stop and speak to give the special one you seek a chance, and maybe say hello with just a glance. Beach of Sun.